Hello everyone, in this video I am going to explain image geometric transformation, which is a topic from digital image processing. So what is spatial or geometric transformation? Now you can see that there are two words, one is geometric and one is transformation. So transformation means change. So we change the change in geometry of an image. So as understood by the name, it means changing the geometry of an image. So changing the geometry of an image is known as geometric transformation. You can see here two images. This is image A and this is image B, and it is written that it is a transform image. T stands for transform image. You can see here there is an object, and on this object there is pixel P. The pixel P has coordinates x, y. X is the row number and y is a column number of pixel. You can see that in transform image, this object, the object that is available in this scene, is displaced in x direction, it is displaced in this direction, it is displaced in y direction, it is slightly rotated. Like you can see that here, this portion is out here, and in this image this portion is slightly rotated, and hence the same pixel, that is pixel Q, in this image will have a different coordinates, that is U, V, wherein U represent the row number and V represents the column number of this pixel. This is row number and this is column number of pixel, and here same it was represented by X is the row number and Y is column number. So X and Y are displaced, they are rotated, and the geometry of this image is changed, and this is known as geometric transformation. This is also known as spatial transformation. This is not Fourier transform, Laplace transform, Z transform. This transform is a spatial transform. It is geometric transformation. So why is it used? Why geometric transformation? Why we are studying this? Now let's assume an example. Some person is clicking pictures of the same place. That means place is same, the scene is same, but picture is clicked at different times of the day or different times of the year to visualize the changes. Every time he clicks the picture, it is not necessary that the clicks the picture at the same exact angle. That means when a person clicks the image or picture of the same scene or same object at different times, then it is not necessary that he captures that picture with the same angle or from the same distance. So that changes the geometry of image. So for better visualization, he can align all the images at the same angle using geometric transformation. You can see here these two pictures. This is picture A and this is picture B. Both are taken, in both the images object is same, the scene is same, but here the camera is slightly rotated, here the size is changed, here the height of image is smaller than height of this image, here this is height of image, and here height of image is only this much, and even the you can say the length is different and camera is slightly rotated. So what happens when we want to align these images, then we have to correct this image. This is known as geometric transformation of image. Why it has happened? Because of changing the position of camera, by changing the angle of camera, or maybe reason it is taken from different viewpoint or by different sensors. So when we want to align both these images, then we have to perform geometric transformation on this image. So what I have to do, what I will do, I will change the height of image and I will correct the rotation. And after doing this, now I can align these two images by putting them one above the other. So this is the reason we need geometric transformation. Now there are different types of geometric transformation. You can see here, if this is an original image, there are different types of transformation like translation, rotation, scaling, shear, affine transform, and this is non-linear transformation. So let's learn each transform one by one. Let's start with the translation. What is meaning of translation? You can see here, this is original image, and here you can see that it is a translated image. See, the position of original image should be this one, but actually in translated image, this is the position of image. So image is translated in X and Y direction. So there is this, the translation in X direction is represented by T suffix X, that is TX, and translation of image in Y direction is represented by TY. Let's assume that in this example, this image is translated by 15 pixels. That means position of 15 pixels. And in Y direction, it is translated by position of 13 pixels, say. So translation becomes 15, 13. So suppose let's take this image. Now in this image, suppose this is any pixel. This is exact pixel which is available at the corner. So what is the coordinate of this pixel? The coordinate of this pixel will be 0, 0, because this pixel is at the left top corner, that is in the 0th row and 0th column of image. Now this is a transformation matrix. This is a translation matrix, and this is very, very standard. We cannot change this matrix. So it is given by 1, 0, TX, 0, 1, TY. So what happens when we multiply this matrix by this X and Y coordinates? That means suppose we multiply, that means for this particular pixel, suppose we take this particular pixel at 0, 0, that means 0th row and 0th column, and we put here 0 and 0, and if we put here TX is equals to 15 and TY is equals to 13, and then we calculate U and V. What is U and V? U and V will be the new coordinates of same pixel. That means the pixel that was available here, that will get translated in X and Y direction, and here you will find the same pixel. So entire image will get shifted, or you can say translated, in X and Y direction. So this is known as translation. So suppose we have this image, and if we apply the same matrix on this image, we will get this image back. Or if we have this image, and if we apply this TX, TY on this image, we will get this image. So here for getting this, we have to do it inverse. And for this, we can multiply with the same matrix. So this is known as translation matrix. Now next is rotation. So here you can see that this technique rotates an image by specified angle and by given axis or point. You can see that this is a sample image and this is a rotated image. And this is a rotation matrix, cos theta minus sine theta, cos theta. And what is theta? Theta is the angle of rotation. You can see here example, suppose here the rotation angle is theta. That means what happens, suppose this is any pixel of this image, whose coordinates are 20, 40. That means x-axis, row number 20 and column number 40, and this is a particular pixel. Now scene is same, the image is of the same scene, but it is captured from different camera angle, from different viewpoint. So where is this same pixel in this image? The same pixel is available here. You can see here this objects, and same pixel in this image is available here. So in this image, what are the coordinates of same pixel? Here the coordinates of this pixel are 12, 0. That means in this image, this pixel has coordinates 20, 40, and here the same pixel has coordinates 12, 0. So what happened here? There is a rotation in the image. So what happens? And that rotation angle is 0. Now when we want to align these two images one above the another like this, for that we need to do the geometric transformation of this image. So what we have to do, again it will give us, suppose x comma y, we get this 20, 40 as x and y, or for every pixel we have to calculate, but I'm giving you just an example. Suppose for this particular pixel, if we put here 20 and here 40, and we know how much is the angle of rotation, that also we have to calculate how much is, and there are different techniques for calculating the angle theta. So right now just assume that we know what is angle theta, and if we multiply this x and y with this rotation matrix, then you will get new coordinates, that is u and v, and here you will get the same pixel, that u is equals to 12 and v is equals to 0, and that image will get, and when you apply this equation on every pixel of this image, then you will get this rotated image. That means this image will get slightly rotated and then will get exactly aligned to this image. there will be an exact alignment on the image you can see here. So this is a use of geometric transformation if there is a rotation. Now next is scaling. What is scaling? Scaling means resizing an image, which means an image is made bigger or it is made smaller. But scene is same here. You can see that the same image, but there is a scaling, there is change in length, and there is a change in height of image. So we can resize an image in terms of scaling factor, and this is known as scaling matrix. So what happens again? Let's take an example. Suppose we have this particular sample image, and here coordinates are image size is 300 by 400. That means there are 300 rows and 400 columns. There are 300 rows and 400 columns, and we want to transform it into an image of shape 600 by 200. That means we want to make 600 rows and 200 columns of the same scene. So what happens? The scaling in x direction will be 600. This 600 divided by 300. So scaling factor is 2, because we want to double the height. Here we want to double the height and we want to make width half. What we are doing? We are doubling the height and we are making this width half of the original size. Because scaling in x direction will be 600 by 300 equal to 2, and similarly scaling in y direction will be 200 by 400, that is 1 by 2, that is half. So what happens when we multiply every pixel coordinates of this image with this scaling matrix, putting sx is equals to 2 and sy is equals to 1 by 2, and then we plot this u and v here, then we will get this image. This is known as scaling transformation. Now next is shearing. What happens in shearing? You can see here there is a vertical shearing and here it is horizontal shearing. Shearing an image means shifting the pixel value either horizontally or vertically. Basically, this shifts some part of image to one direction and other parts to some other direction. Horizontal shearing will shift the upper part of the image to right and lower part to the left. You can see here, actually, this was the original image. The original image should be like this, but you can see that there is a shift. This corner is shifted here. This corner is shifted here. This corner is shifted here. That means on the upper side, it is shifted towards right. The corners are shifted towards right. And on the lower side, this corner is shifted here. Lower side, the corners are shifted towards left. And on the upper side, corners are shifted towards right. This is known as horizontal shearing. Same thing happens when in vertical shearing, this corner of the image is shifted out here and this corner is shifted out here. This is known as vertical shearing. And we need to perform transformation on this image if you want to bring it back to the original image, but it cannot be done by a simple formula. For that, we have to find out control points in the image and then we have to map that control points to the original image. Now next is a rigid body transformation. What is rigid body transformation? It is a combination of translation and rotation. So it is a combination of translation and rotation. You can see here, this is image and this is a rigid body transformation of same object. So if you see, this is axis. In the axis, it is shown there are two points on the object, that is P and Q. And in translated or in a rigid body transformed image, the same point is represented by G into bracket P and G into bracket Q. So here the translation is also there because P point is shifted till this point. So there is translation in X direction and there is translation in Y direction. So there is a translation in X and Y direction, and this is known as rigid body transformation. And there is a rotation as well. It's not only translation in X and Y, but there is a rotation also, because you can see that in this image, this particular portion is out here, and in this same here, in this, the same portion is in this direction because there is a rotation of object. This is known as rigid body transformation. And if you want to correct this rigid body transformation, you need to know how much is the angle of rotation, you need to know what is translation in X direction, how much is the translation in Y direction, and when you multiply this, by original matrix, that is here you can write x coordinates of original matrix, that is x, y, and here 1, and then here you will get uv coordinates of this rigid body transform image. Here you will get u, v, and 1. So this matrix is used for rigid body transformation correction. Next is similarity transform. What is similarity transform? In similarity transform, it is a combination of translation, rotation, and scaling. All three things are happening. You can see here, suppose this is the original image, which is shown in the purple color. And in the red color, you can show that there is a scaling. This image is bigger. So scaling is there. You can see there, these corners are shifted. These corners are shifted, so there is a rotation and there is a translation, because there is a translation in this direction and in this direction. So all three transformations are there, and this kind of transformation, if it exists in the image, it is said that it is a similarity transform. And to correct similarity transform, we have to use this matrix, this transformation matrix, which is given by S, stands for scaling factor. S is scaling factor, that is S cos theta. Theta is for rotation angle. Theta is for rotation angle. S cos theta minus S sine theta. Tx is translation in x direction. And S sine theta, S cos theta, again Ty is translation in y direction. And these are coordinates of pixels of original image. So when you apply this multiplication on every pixel, coordinate of every pixel, then for every pixel you will get new coordinates. So either you represent by x dash, y dash, or you earlier we have used u and v for this, so you can use this. This is known as similarity transform. Another is projective transform. In projective transform, you can see that this is original image and this is projective, it is image after projective transformation. In this particular transformation, it is similar when you capture the image of a long road. So, or you can say that the image of railway track. So how it appears? It appears that it is not parallel anymore and it will join. It will look like this. This is known as projective transformation. Actually, they are not joined, but in image, it will look like this. This is known as projective transformation. Next is affine transformation. Very, very important transformation. That is affine transformation. It is a combination of translation, rotation, scale, and shear. So everything is there in the image. That means it is taken from different angle of view. The camera is rotated. It is taken from different distance from the object, and shear is there. So all type of changes are there in the image. That is known as affine transformation. And affine transformation is the transformation that preserves collinearity and ratio of distances. So you can see here, this is affine transform image. Everything is changed. So then how to calculate what is constant in this image, in this kind of image? So what is constant in this type of images? Parallel lines remains parallel. So you can use this feature for getting the original image or for selecting the control points or the ratio. Suppose you are taking area of these four squares and area of this particular, then that will be ratio. Ratio is same. Area is not same, but ratio of squares may be same, or a ratio of length that will remain same in affine transform. So in affine transform, what remains constant? The parallel lines remains parallel and ratios remains parallel. It may be ratio of length, it may be ratio of area, it may be any ratio. And you have to select such feature points to get this image back to original image. So these are again with the example original image. So this is rigid translation and rotation, rigid body transformation. The image is translated and rotated. Similarity transform, it is translation, rotation, and scaling. Affine transform is a combination of translation, rotation, scaling, shear, everything. And this is deformed image, slightly bigger than this. So this is 3D example of three-dimensional spatial transformation. You can see that this is the original image. Original image means it is taken by some different camera, different sensor. Different camera means different sensor. There are different sensors of camera, MRI image, X-ray, ultrasonic camera is different, or PET scanning or CT scanning. These are different kind of imaging system in which the sensors are different. The camera sensors used are different. So here different sensor is used, the angle of capturing is different, the view angle is different. This is an image of brain. There is a side view, here it is top view. This is MRI image, this is some PT CT scan image. So in this you can see everything is different. So this is known as three-dimensional spatial transformation. There is the displacement in X direction, displacement in Y direction, there is rotation. So this is 3D spatial transformation. So why geometric transformation is required? Why we need to correct this transformation or spatial geometric transformation? So it is required for image registration. This is very, very important when you want to do image registration. What is image registration? Image registration is the process of transforming different sets of data into one coordinate system. When we want to bring the images captured at different times, at different view angles, by different sensor, when we want to bring in all images captured in same coordinate system, that time we need to transform this image by using geometric transformation. You can see here, this is a brain image. These are captured by different sensors, different cameras, CT, PET, MRI, fMRI, functional MRI, and so many. And every image looks different. You can see that these images are captured at different times. Here you can see the tumor is small and here the tumor is bigger. So these images are taken at different times. These images are taken from different view angle. The distance of object and camera is different. This is a closer view. The scene is same. This is a closer view and this is a far view. You can see that there is a rotation in these two images. So camera is rotated. It is taken from different view angle. You can see that these images again taken from different viewpoint, the different coverage is there. Here the full these flowers are covered, here it is on the left hand side, and here very few, you can see very little of this flower. So images are taken from different view points. When you want to bring in these images in the same coordinate system, for that is known as image registration, and for that you need geometric transformation. So what are the application of geometric transformation? In many applications, it is necessary to combine multiple images of the same scene acquired by different sensors or same sensors from same or different viewpoints. Now let's see, this is one image. This is the image of some patient having a brain tumor. This is a SPECT image, single photon emission tomography, SPECT. This is SPECT image. Single photon emission computed tomographic image. You can see that here the boundary of this brain is not very much clear, but the tumor is very clearly seen. And this is image of same patient. This is a MRI image. This is MRI image. In this MRI image, the anatomy of brain is very clearly visible. The boundaries are clearly available, but this image is rotated, taken by different sensor, that is MRI, and here tumor is not visible. Here tumor is visible, but it is difficult for doctors to identify where exactly it is located because the boundaries of brain are not clear. Here the boundary of brain is clear, but the tumor is not clear. So here also it becomes difficult for doctors to identify where exactly the tumor exists. So what happens in such case, and here it is rotated also. So what we have to do now for complete information, doctors needs to fuse these two images, the fusion of medical images like PET MRI, CT PET, CT MRI, etc. for diagnosis. So what happens when doctor want to fuse these images? He cannot fuse this rotated and this straight one together because that will give a wrong information. So for that, there in this image there is a geometric transformation. It is taken by different sensor and from different angle of camera. So when doctor want to fuse these two images, these need to be in same coordinate system. That means before fusion, this needs to be rotated in this direction with the same angle, whatever is the angle of rotation, or if there is a translation, or if there is a scaling between these two, scale difference between these two images. And then when it is fused, you can see that this is a complete correct image in which the boundaries are clearly visible and in which the tumor is also clearly visible. That will certainly help doctors for correct diagnosis. So this geometric transformation or image registration is used for image fusion in medical applications. So I hope you understood what is image transformation, why it is used. Very, very important is it is used for medical applications. It is also used to increase or also to generate the panoramic view of a scenes taken by the camera, satellite images. If from satellite images, if we want to make a broader, you can say, view. So if you want to stitch the images together, taken at different angles from different viewpoints, then there also geometric transformations need to be done. So it was all about geometric transformation. I hope you understood the concept. Thank you very much. Thanks for watching.